Hey guys, Megan here. Welcome to this video. Today I was having a bit of a creative block because I didn't really know what to talk about. And so I figured I'd talk about that. I've had a really busy weekend. I'm sort of tired, a little bit bloated because I ate way too much food. And it feels good. It's one of those lazy, yummy feeling where you're just and that's how I'm feeling. So I thought, okay, well, I'm going to be inspired to say something today because I'm wanting to put my message out there on a daily basis. And so I grabbed a book that I've been sort of reading on and off, and it's Julia Cameron's book. Just grab it, The Artist's Way. And I was just reading through it and nothing was really inspiring me. And then I came to a passage that I thought I would read to you guys and just contemplate and talk to you about. It's basically when you are blocked or when you get, well, I guess when you don't have inspiration, that you should do the work anyway. And I think one of the things that came up for me with this is if I am blocked, it has a lot to do with, you know, a laziness. Perhaps there's a laziness there. I think for today, it was just I was really bloated and tired and just couldn't feel like it. But there's also the idea of, okay, if I am blocked, but I know my purpose and I know what I want to be doing, speaking and writing and getting out there more, then I have to push through that block, whatever that block is, and just do the work. And it doesn't have to be perfect. So whatever it is, there's a message in it. So let me just read the passage here. It's basically saying, never ever judge a fledgling piece of work too quickly, and be willing to paint or write badly while your ego yelps resistance, which is what I've been doing before shooting this video. I was really resisting shooting one because I really didn't have much to say today. And your bad writing may be the syntactical breakdown necessary for a shift in your style, and your lousy painting may be pointing you in a new direction. And art needs time to incubate, to sprawl a little, to be ungainly and misshapen, and finally emerge as itself. And the ego hates this fact. The ego wants instant gratification and the addictive hit of the acknowledged win. But the need to win now is a need to win approval from others. And as an antidote, we must learn to approve ourselves, and showing up for the work is the win that matters. So I just said, okay, well, what am I learning here is that I have to show up, and knowing this, that I want to show up on a daily basis because I have a bigger purpose that I'm going after and a bigger outcome. It's once I got back to, okay, well, I'm being lazy, so what do? I had to go back again, as I have to do on a daily basis, to why I'm doing this in the first place. And it's essentially that I'm a performer, and my whole career in the past has been to help other people put their creativity out there, whether I was representing a musicians, whether I was presenting software, whether whatever it was, I was always promoting and pushing or marketing, not pushing, but promoting other people's creativity. And for me, there was a part of me that was jealous a bit of the people that I was promoting because I was promoting them and I wasn't promoting me and my ideas and my creativity. And that's what my mission is from now on, is I am a creative soul. I'm a performer. That's been my whole life. And yet it was pushed down for so long because I was chasing other dreams and chasing other paths. So now I'm, you know, going after what I want, being a writer, being that performer, being that speaker. So for me to hone it and get better at it is I have to consistently show up and do the work, and do the work no matter, some days it's not going to be perfect, some days it's going to be, there's no message there. But the more I show up, the more I am being that person that I want to be. So I guess for you, however you want to take this, or I keep wobbling my computer, however you want to take this, perhaps you, if you ever get stuck on anything, on any goal or anything that you want to reach, just go back to the core of why you want it and just remind yourself to do that. And even if you have to do it on a daily basis, and you have to keep reminding yourself why you want to go after what you want. Why do you want it? What is the bigger reason and the bigger mission that you have? So thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a great Sunday. I'm back home now after a really, really busy weekend, but it was an amazing weekend. I had such a good time catching up with all my friends. Now Devin and I are just going to chill. We were going to go for dinner, this Thai restaurant that we went for our first date, where we got in a snowstorm, if you could believe it. Our first date, we were in a snowstorm, and we went to this Thai restaurant, and his car got stuck, which was really cool. Other people had to get the car out. I guess he didn't have winter tires on, but it was funny. So we're going to go there tonight, and I'm super bloated because I ate too much the last couple days. So I said, I'm not hungry. I don't even know if I'll be able to eat again later on tonight. So we'll see. We'll see. Maybe we'll go. Maybe we won't. Anyway, that's my little story, my little anecdote, and hope you have a wonderful rest of your weekend. Bye.